face is, and stuff like that. Here's another note, this is, I'm not convinced, you know, so. And then he summed it up with the comment, vague but exciting.
There were alternatives to the World Wide Web, but you had to pay to use them.
If we had patented this and asked for royalties, it would have become just yet another network system alongside all the other unsuccessful network systems. But precisely because it was not just completely free, but also published and open, everybody could join. Everybody could look at the code. Everybody could try it out, modify it, add to it. It puts the entire web technology into the public domain for the whole world to use. And I think that was crucial.
Krista!
Hello!
Here. How lovely to see you.
And nice to see you. I've got a present for everyone. It might look much.
Cable, internet! Oh, yeah!
In there. Okay.
Go.
My granny still
what
has
it. What does that noise sound like, darling?
Fax.
We are giving you the internet circa 1997. And we've slowed it down, so it's not going to be fast like your normal broadband.
There are now over 230 million websites on the internet. You're searching. In 1997, there were barely 1.5 million.
I've just searched in Bebo, which is like a social networking site, and it's come up with some weird stuff, very weird stuff.
You're not as excited as you were. Was the internet rubbish, do you think?
Yes.
While commerce seized on the web and dot-com millionaires were made overnight, it allowed everyday users to do something new, to express themselves in a way the whole world could share.
Whatever you type onto the screen, it will turn it into a web page.
This is really, really easy to use. It is really easy to use. Good luck and have fun.
Okay, it's time for this fax machine to be consigned to the garage because we don't need it anymore. Email has arrived.
The arrival of the internet has brought them one step closer to modern life, but Georgie doesn't want them totally sucked back to where they were in 2009.
There's technology all over the house. There's a games console in the sitting room. I thought that was like our final bastion of no technology, wasn't going to be a games console in here. You know how I feel about it. I feel really let down.
Yeah, but this isn't just a games console. This is a PS1.
Life was give us power. 1998 is here. And the tech team have taken pity on the children.
I'll get it. It's me. Oh, yay, got loads of friends.
Even in the late 90s, few pre-teens got their hands on a mobile.
I'm guessing we've all got a new one then.
But the arrival of pay-as-you-go meant that under-18s could go upwardly mobile.
It's a very exciting moment, this. I'm sending the family the first text. Look what you can do.
The text was originally just a free bonus feature.
Now, more texts are sent per day than there are people on the planet.
The popularity of SMS took the mobile phone industry by surprise. But the nation's children would take it to their hearts.
Oh, I have a message from the tech team. Look what you can do now. What does that mean? Oh, we can text now. Huh, that's what I mean.
That clears it.
Oh, someone at the door.
The tech team want to give the family a taste of the consumerist boom years of the late 1990s.
It's the smoothie maker.
When imported technology grew more abundant and everything that came into our homes now had a microchip.
Now, can we just wait? Can we just get it inside?
And that means delivery after delivery.
Oh, blimey, not another one. You got the instructions?
Yep.
Oh, 3/4 cup.
Isn't it important to get the ingredients just right in bread?
Then you need to twist it in, and then I think we just go start.
But the boom in cheap electronics had its downside.
I've got smoothie makers, I've got steamers, I've got little chopping things. It's horrendous. What advantage is that then? Apart from me having to do more blasted washing up. And now it can go. Thanks very much. Off to the garage with it.
The family's garage has become a museum of obsolete technology, with the biggest contribution coming from the most recent decade. During the 90s, electronics plummeted in price. Even computers were getting cheaper by 25% every year. Britain may have stopped making much in the way of electronics, but it became great at chucking them away. Now the average modern gadget has a lifespan of just over a year.
And the knife block behind you.
That looks all right, actually.
With only 2 days left in the 1990s, the children are keen to know whether they'll be allowed to use the adults-only living room when they return to normal life.
Should be a family.
I don't see why you feel so hard done by. You've got your own room with your own TV and your own Sky.
No, because
why do you want to come into the adult room?
Because for the whole thing, you've been saying that it's nice that we've been doing things together.
Even no, Mum's been saying that.
So have you. So have you.
Hang on. All those in favour of family in the previously known as adult room?
Yes.
So that's when there were adults around?
Four in favour.
And there's someone else in the adult room.
The only condition I'd attach is that Georgie and I decide what we're watching in there, if there's something on television we want to watch. I'm not backing down from that.
No, I think it's a family decision.
No way, I'm not backing down from that. Because I'm not going to want to watch Hannah Montana, am I?
Neither are we. But if you're just watching things that the rest of us don't want to watch, then it's going to just turn into an Adam room.
I think we need to talk about it after we get through this.
Considering how much time and resources we actually dedicate to all the children, it's nice for us to have somewhere that belongs to us, really.
It's not a job we do.
Well, no, I know it's not a job, but it still happens, and without wanting to sound selfish, maybe it does sound selfish, but I think it's important to have your own little space and time.
It's 1999. The family's experience is nearly at an end, but so was the world if some computer experts were to be believed.
The millennium could be a disaster for all industrial societies. Every electronic device could act irrationally. It's been the computer industry's dirty little secret for years.
The problem's arisen because, to save space, computers have always stored dates as 2 digits instead of 4. It worked fine until now, but come the year 2000, computers may think it's 1900 and simply fail.
If we don't act, then the result will be loss of money, of power and influence, perhaps, on a disastrous scale.
We'd become so reliant on technology that the thought of losing it all really did feel like the end of the world. If the family got the Millennium Bug, it would be a bit like them going back to 1970. And our family would actually be able to cope rather well, as they've been able to cope without computers. But, you know, it was a big deal at the time. A very, very big deal.
Of course, 2000 came along without all our computers crashing, leading many to question what all the fuss was about. The Sullivan Barnes family know that their Millennium Party won't be spoiled by global technological meltdown. To entertain tonight's guests, they're cherry-picking from the 30 years of retro gizmos they've accumulated. The widest choice clearly comes from the decade they've just lived through.
Getting into the 90s was just gadget after gadget, but technology of the 90s has not been a disappointment to me. It's done what it was supposed to do. You know, accurate stuff, worked reasonably well, and, you know, some of the design was a little bit shonky in modern standards, but generally I thought it was all right, actually.
Cheers, Adam!
Hello?
It's amazing how it's all changed, like, from the first mobile phone to being about that big, to them now being about that big, or smaller.
technology moved through the house and sort of started off in one room and then kind of ferreted its way out to various other parts of the house, and people kind of moved with it.
All of a sudden we like split up quite quickly, still not as much as we did before it.
And it has become progressively more a question of territory and ownership and, you know, this is my domain.
The tech team don't just bring a bottle to the party. They're making one final delivery, another toy for the grown-ups.
It's the ultimate 90s party accessory.